Hi everyone, in this presentation we are going to study about heteropolysaccharides. We already learned that heteropolysaccharide means they contain different sugar, two or more different sugar, so they are called heteropolysaccharide. So heterosaccharides in plants and heteropolysaccharides in animals. Okay, in plants can have example of agar, gum, pectin, so and so, but in animal the heteropolysaccharide in this is in plants. Heteropolysaccharide in animals or especially in human beings is called glycosaminoglycans. Okay, heteropolysaccharide is also called glycans. Polysaccharide also called glycans, or in short we can write GAGS, G-A-G-S. So heteropolysaccharides in human beings or in animals we can name as glycosaminoglycans or GAGS. Other name they have given to these heteropolysaccharides in human beings is also called mucopolysaccharides. This is very important as far as our health and diseases. Hereafter we call GAGS or mucopolysaccharides. So example for mucopolysaccharides is, have you heard hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, keratin, it's not keratin, keratin sulfate, dermatan sulfate. You can see lot of sulfate, that means majority of the mucopolysaccharides are sulfated except hyaluronic acid. Okay, I'll explain later. Heparin and also heparin sulfate. Okay, these are the example for glycosaminoglycans or GAGS or mucopolysaccharides. Okay, this is other name for glycosaminoglycans. So let me explain the structure or glycosaminoglycans. Actually these glycosaminoglycans or mucopolysaccharides they are unbranched. Heteropolysaccharides can be branched or unbranched, but especially these glycosaminoglycans, they are unbranched and they are repeating disaccharides. In the sense, suppose this is glucose, this will be galactose. Suppose this is glucose, this will be galactose. Suppose this is glucose, this will be galactose. Again, this will be glucose, this will be galactose. This will be linear unbranched polymer of repeating disaccharide. Repeating disaccharide. So here there will be glucose, here there will be galactose. Okay, they are repeating disaccharides. Number one point, they are unbranched, they are repeating disaccharides. The third point is, the one of the component in this, they are repeating disaccharides, the one of the component is amino sugar. Another component is uronic acid. Okay, what is this amino sugar? Amino sugar, okay, glucose is a hexose. We know that, so we will remember beta, up, down, up, CH2OH. Okay. All other place it will be H. Okay, this is the structure of glucose. So in mucopolysaccharide, one component will be amino sugar. So amino sugar nothing but, so this is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, carbon number 6. So here I forgot to write H here. Okay. So the second carbon, the hydroxyl group attached to the second carbon is replaced by amino group. Okay, it's replaced by amino group. Okay, let me erase this. So it's replaced by amino group. So initially it was glucose, now it will become glucosamine. Suppose this is a galactose. What is the difference between galactose? This OH group will come here, this will come here, then it will become galactose, then it will become galactosamine. So majority of mucopolysaccharides or glycosaminoglycans either glucose or galactose and their derivative. So this is glucosamine. If OH is here, because glucose and galactose are epimers with respect to carbon number 4. One component will be amino sugar. Whether glucosamine, if it is glucose, we call glucosamine. If it is galactose, we call it as galactose. Another component will be uronic acid. Again, let me write the structure of glucose. Uronic acid, there is an exception. The keratin sulfate does not contain uronic acid. Remaining all mucopolysaccharides contain uronic acid and amino sugar. We remember like this, up, down, up, down, up. Ca2OH, 6 carbon atom. Okay, all other place H. Okay, this is glucose. So now you learned how to write the structure of glucose. Uronic acid means the 6th carbon atom, it is replaced by acid group COOH. So but at physiological pH they will appear like this, COO minus. Okay, let me erase, I will replace this one. So COO minus, this will become, this is, since it is glucose, we can write this glucuronic acid. Suppose this is a galactose. Okay, if this OH comes here and this H comes here, it will become galacturonic acid. And this glucuronic acid, there is an isomer. Suppose if I write the same glucuronic acid in this manner, so how to remember, up, down, this COO group is here. So this is the spatial configuration. Then all other place we will write H here. So this will become, it's a glucose actually, but it's called iodouronic acid, isomer of glucuronic acid. It's called iodouronic acid. So either we'll see glucuronic acid or galactouronic acid, or sometimes we'll see isomer of glucuronic acid, iodouronic acid. So we go back, this glycosaminoglycans are unbranched, they are unbranched repeating disaccharides, and one component is amino sugar and another component erosinic acid. Only exception is keratin, it's not keratin, okay, keratin sulfate. So glycosaminoglycans or GAS or mucopolysaccharides are nothing but amino sugar and uronic acid. So they are polymer of amino sugar and uronic acid. So they are polymer of amino sugar and uronic acid, repeating unbranched. So they will appear like this, and they are linked to a protein. They are linked to a protein, attached to a protein. So this protein is called core protein. So these are all just polymer repeating disaccharides or GACs, polymer of repeating disaccharides. So this is like a bottle brush appearance. It looks like a bottle brush, right? Bottle brush appearance. So like this, this is one monomer of glycosaminoglycans. So like this, many glycosaminoglycans can be linked to a link protein. Suppose this is a link protein. So here we can have one more monomer of glycosaminoglycan polymers. Okay, that is core protein, like this. And this side also we can have like this. So this is how proteoglycans, proteoglycan means proteins and carbohydrates together. So they will form a proteoglycans. Glycan means polysaccharide. So mucopolysaccharides are repeating unbranched disaccharides. They are unbranched repeating disaccharides. One component is amino sugar, another component is uronic acid. Exception is keratin sulfate. Almost all glycosaminoglycans are sulfated, except there's an exception. Like uronic acid, there is a keratin sulfate is exception. Here hyaluronic acid is unsulfated, this is an exception. Keratin sulfate is an exception for uronic acid, hyaluronic acid is the exception for sulfated. So it is not sulfated. So we know the example, we know the structure. What is the function? So if you see glycosaminoglycans, so this hyaluronic acid is found, usually found in the joints, synovial fluid. Chondroitin sulfate is found in cartilage and bone, especially calcification site of the bone. Keratin sulfate is found in cornea, even connective tissue and also cartilage. Dermatin sulfate is found in the skin and artery or vessels, blood vessels, artery and veins. So heparin is found in mast cell, so intracellular mast cell. Heparin sulfate again is found in the skin, fibroblast, and even in aorta, or wall of the aorta. So important is this hyaluronic acid, which is found in the synovial fluid. This is bone and cartilage, chondroitin sulfate, keratin sulfate, connective tissue, cornea, dermatin sulfate, skin and blood vessels. So we know that their occurrence, example for mucopolysaccharides. What is the function of this one? Okay, that is very important. So function, they are the major component of extracellular matrix, or they forms a ground substances in between the cells. Except hyaluronic acid, almost all glycosamino glycans contain sulfated group. Maybe it can be here or anywhere, sulfated group. So since they have negatively charged carboxyl group and negatively charged sulfate group, they have a lot of negatively charged group. So these negatively charged group can attract lot of water molecule. So they forms a gel-like material. This gel-like material actually makes a cushion for joint. It's a cushion effect. All gags contain lot of negatively charged group. They can attract water and they form a gel-like material. So they give a cushion effect. Not only cushion effect, they give elasticity. Elasticity for the cartilage or maybe from the tendon because of this negatively charged. Or elasticity, or we can write, there is a good word called a resilience to the cartilage or tendon, or strength to the cartilage or tendon or for the ligament. So because of this negatively charged, they repel each other, so they give a resilience or elasticity, and also they form a gel-like substance, so they give cushion. Even if we fall down from a height, because of synovial fluid present in our joint, there will not much of damage to the bones, because in between the bone we have a synovial fluid. Synovial fluid nothing but it contains hyaluronic acid. Okay, it is a carbohydrate, it is a heteropolysaccharide, or it is a mucopolysaccharide. What is the importance of this? The importance is these mucopolysaccharide hydrolyze in lysosome by a specific enzymes. If any defect in the hydrolysis of this mucopolysaccharide inside the lysosome, they land up in disease. That disease we call mucopolysaccharidosis. So very good example is Hunter syndrome. Another is Hurler's syndrome. This is actually failure of Hurler's. Hunter syndrome is due to failure of metabolism of heparin sulfate. So heparin sulfate could not able to hydrolyze or degrade in the lysozyme. Heparin sulfate, they will accumulate inside the lysozyme and leads to Hunter syndrome. And Hurler's syndrome is mainly due to failure of hydrolysis of dermatan sulfate. So we will study the detailed clinical features of this disease in the coming videos. At this moment, glycosaminoglycans or heteropolysaccharides or mucopolysaccharides are very important. They forms major part of extracellular matrix, joint fluid or synovial fluid, skin, cartilage, bone, blood vessels, wall of the blood vessels, so even cornea. So they form major functions of extracellular matrix. That's about heteropolysaccharides or GAGs or mucopolysaccharides. Thanks for watching.